Hello, my dear children. This is your computer teacher. In computers, today we will start chapter 11, that is Internet Services. So let's get started. Millions and millions of computers with internet access communicate with each other 24/7. This shows the amount of activity happening on the internet, which acts as a global network platform. The services available on the net are colossal. Some of the basic and important services of internet are emailing, online chat, video conferencing, file transfer, internet forum, cloud computing, OneDrive, and so on. So these all kinds of important services are given by the internet. ये सारी services हमें internet से मिलती है. So let's see one by one what are the services. Firstly, social networking sites. Social networking is the group of individuals who share their thoughts, ideas, activities, events, interests, photos, messages and videos over the internet. बहुत सारे persons का एक group बना होता है social networking sites पे, जहाँ पे they can share so many things to each other. In social networking websites, every user has a profile which contains information about them. A user can also invite other people to join these websites no matter what their hobbies, beliefs or interests are. Some of the popular social networking sites are Facebook, LinkedIn, Hi5, etc. So, social networking sites like Facebook पे हर person का एक profile बना होता है and हम लोग किसी को भी अपने friends और relatives को invite कर सकते हैं, अपने groups बना सकते हैं and उनसे अपनी ideas, concepts and pictures, photos, videos share कर सकते हैं. Okay, now the next service provided by the internet is microblogging and Twitter. Microblogging is a new form of communication in which users can share their thoughts via short post distributed by SMS, short messaging service, mobile phones, emails, digital audio or the web. Some of the most notable services are Twitter, Tumblr, Plurk, Jeku, etc. सो माइक्रोब्लॉगिंग हमारी एक ऐसी सर्विस है इंटरनेट पे जिसको यूज़ करके यूज़र्स अपनी थॉट्स एक ब्लॉग के फॉर्म में शेयर करते हैं. जैसे ट्विटर पे या एसएमएस के थ्रू दे कैन शेयर देयर थॉट्स. सी ए फैक्ट फाइल, ये पिक्चर आप देख रहे हैं, दिस इज़ जॉक डोर्सी. ये हमारे ट्विटर जो कि एक बहुत पॉपुलर सोशल नेटवर्किंग साइट है उसके फाउंडर हैं. ओके, नाउ ट्विटर इज़ एन ऑनलाइन सोशल नेटवर्किंग साइट दैट इज़ www.twitter.com. That allows user to send and receive text-based messages known as tweets. A tweet is a restricted up to 140 characters. With a Twitter account, you can choose to follow other members and receive their tweets on your page. Moreover, other people can also follow you. Twitter has gained worldwide popularity and has become one of the top 10 most visited websites on the internet. It has been described as SMS of the internet. So Twitter is a social networking site using which we can create our account, we can follow others and others can follow us and we can send messages that is called tweets and it is known as the SMS of the internet. Now the next service provided by internet is internet forum. The term forum refers to a discussion area on a website where people with common interest can communicate in the form of posted messages. It is a system that allows users to send, read and reply to messages on a particular subject in real time. A forum can be focused on any topic such as language, technology, sports, music, religion, etc. To become a member of the forum, a user is required to register into a particular website. When the applicant is approved to be the member of the forum by the administrator, then one can set his or her username and password and thereafter one can navigate within the forum. To read or view the topic of interest, simply click on it. Similarly, one can read the posted messages of any specific discussion and then users can reply to any of the messages. A forum is different from a chat room. In a chat room, people usually chat at the same time, whereas in a forum, members in a discussion group post messages that can be read by the other members whenever they log. So internet forum is a discussion area. एक discussion area है जहाँ पे आप लोग के दिमाग में कोई question है then you can post that question and then other persons who are staying anywhere in the world they can reply on that. ठीक है, इस तरह से एक discussion हम लोग net पे कर सकते हैं using the forum. Now see this note that some of the commonly used forum software are PHP BB and FUD forum. Okay, now the next service is cloud computing. Cloud is defined as a set of hardware, networks, storage, interfaces and services which combine together to deliver different aspects of computing as a service over a network or internet. Applications such as email, web conferencing, customer relationship management, CRM all run in cloud. Google Docs, Microsoft OneDrive, Dropbox, etc. are some of the common examples of free or low-cost online storage for users. Cloud computing refers to manipulating, configuring and accessing the applications online. Basically, cloud computing means हम लोग अपना सारा कुछ अपना network पे, internet पे store कर रहे हैं. ठीक है, अपनी सारी files, videos, photos हम लोग आजकल Google Drive पे store कर लेते हैं. तो वो सब कहाँ store हैं? Internet पे. वहाँ से हम कहीं से भी कभी भी access कर सकते हैं. All the services like hardware, storage, ये सारी services हमको network पे मिल रही हैं. कौन दे रहा है ये सर्विसेज? जैसे गूगल डॉक्स पे हम स्टोर कर सकते हैं, वन ड्राइव, ड्रॉप बॉक्स, गूगल ड्राइव, यहाँ पे आप अपने आप सारे फोटोज़, वीडियोस और आपके जितनी भी इन्फॉर्मेशन है आप अपनी स्टोर कर सकते हैं. यहाँ पे हमें स्टोरेज फैसिलिटी मिल जाती है और बिल्कुल फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. सो दैट इज़ कॉल्ड क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग. दस वी कैन से दैट द क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग इज अ मॉडल फॉर इनेबलिंग कन्वीनियंट ऑन डिमांड नेटवर्क एक्सेस टू अ शेयर्ड पूल ऑफ कंप्यूटिंग. एग्जाम्पल, नेटवर्क, सर्वर्स, स्टोरेज, सॉफ्टवेयर, एप्लीकेशंस एंड सर्विसेज that can be released with minimum efforts or service provider interaction. Now let us see an example, that is OneDrive. ठीक है, क्लाउड कंप्यूटर का एग्जाम्पल है OneDrive. OneDrive previously known as SkyDrive or Windows Live SkyDrive is a free online storage facility offered by Microsoft company. In February 2014, it has been officially renamed from SkyDrive to OneDrive. पहले इसको SkyDrive बोलते थे, now its name is OneDrive. Means one place where you can store all your photos, videos, documents and that too free of cost. Free में आप store करेंगे सारी चीज़ें. It allows user to specify the files they want to keep private, make public or share with audience. It is a password protected storage area in the cloud that allows user to upload and synchronize data to cloud storage and then access it from web browser. Means cloud पे हम अपना data store कर सकते हैं, that is internet पे हमारा data upload हो सकता है और using the web browser हम अपना data को password protected बना सकते हैं और कहीं से भी उसको access कर सकते हैं. Microsoft originally offered 25 GB free storage space to SkyDrive users but reduced the amount to 7 GB in the year 2012. From September 2013 onwards, it has included 4 premium storage plans to upgrade the storage space. Okay? So children, this much for today. I hope it is clear to you. Thank you. Bye-bye.